Hello, today we want to talk about video accessibility. You might wonder as to why and how can videos be made accessible. Many times people think that just by making captions to a video that is enough to make it accessible. However, that's not completely true because there are people just like myself who might be blind or visually impaired may not be able to read that caption. So we want to be able to navigate and control the video and also understand what's happening in the video. There are two environments that will create a video that makes accessible and one that may not. On the left-hand side, we're going to explore Flash. Flash sometimes can be made accessible, however, most of the time it cannot. It's much better to use the HTML5 environment. And so I'm going to be showing both so that you can get an idea as to how that might work. So we're going to do this Flash player.
Example, link http://theblank, please install or enable.
So down here it says please install or enable.
Blank. Please link Adobe Flash player to view.
And see how difficult this might be. So what I'm trying to do right now is install the video.
Address and search bar, edit, view site information, space, your connection to this site is not secure dialog. Learn more link, select permission for Flash menu button allow. Menu submenu.
So as you can tell, this is why trying to use Flash, it makes it very difficult for somebody who's using the screen reader. Okay,
allow.
Let's do allow.
Your connection to this site is not secure dialog. Select permission for Flash menu button allow. Block. Allow. Menu submenu. Blank. Ask. Default allow. Your connection to this site.
So I'm just kind of going in a loop here. I'm not sure what
menu,
it's
bar,
doing
submenu,
here.
Desktop window.
And as a student, by now I would have just put my hands up and said, forget it. And I have not been able to make it work. So this is one of the reasons, actually a major reason, is why it's such a pain or such a challenge, something that needs Flash to make it work. On the other hand, let's look at the other one, which is the HTML5, and let's see how that looks.
H. To match immaculate with video and accessible video player heading level 1.
So what I did is I went to the accessible video player portion of the screen, which is on your right hand side.
Heading level 2 HTML5 player.
So this is an HTML5 player. Now the cool thing about this one is that it should allow us to have control of the play and rewind and go forward.
Heading level 3 example. Blank. Link to watch immaculate with video description.
So this one has video description. So one of the things I wanted to add about accessibility is that, again, just having captions is not enough. So we have to have something what we call audio description. And audio description, I would say, is equivalent to having alt text and images. The audio description, just like what it sounds like, it adds description to the video so that we are also able to enjoy and understand what's going on in the videos.
Button watch later. Link to watch immaculate. Button watch later.
So as you can hear, it says button watch later.
Menu button submenu share.
Share.
Button play.
Play.
Button play.
Play. So let's go ahead and we're going to play it. Once I play it, I'm going to assume that other controls will appear, allowing me to rewind and perform those commands, those tasks.
The whatchamacallit.
A small purse with a zipper lies on the ground.
One morning, Peep, Quack, and Chirp discovered something very odd.
So as you can hear, you heard the gentleman describe what was happening right there. And also, it's allowing me to pause. And also now, there's a mute button.
Slider 100% volume.
And there's a slider, it's a volume slider.
016/850.
It tells me how much of the movie I've watched so far.
Toggle button not pressed subtitles/closed captions.
And this is a subtitle or closed caption portion.
Menu button submenu settings.
And it's settings.
Link watch on YouTube.com.
Watch on YouTube. That's actually what it's trying to say.
Button full screen.
And full
button
screen.
Full screen.
So as you can see, Link there are controls there that enables me to control the movie. So I'm going to go ahead and press play again. Actually, I'm going to mute
button
it.
Mute. Unmute.
And then I'm going to press play. And the reason because I want you to listen to the screen reader to find the other controls.
Button unmute. Slider 100% volume muted. 016/850. Toggle button not pressed. Subtitle/menu button. Submenu settings. Link watch on YouTube button full screen. Slider seek slider.
There it is. This is what I was looking for. So here's the seek slider. So this allows me to go forward on the movie and the video, or go back on the video. Land. So I'm gonna do that. So I'm gonna
button, slider seek slider focus mode.
Go in there.
104/850. 105/850.
So as soon as I hit left arrow or right arrow, it moves backwards or moves forward.
Pause button.
So it gives me total independence of being able to manipulate the video, unlike the flash, which I struggled and even able to get it running. So I hope that gives you an insight as to how video accessibility is so important. Thank you.